Hey, it's me, MLB. Here is chapter 9 of Serendipity. This one's titled First Move. You blushed. Oh, I don't know about that. You laughed with embarrassment. Just wait and see, she replied with a cryptic smirk, like she knew something was coming. You giggled nervously with an okay and backed away. Your first day went well. You were in and out of Deku's office a lot to confirm dates and times for events, and he was only too happy to see you there. You got home that afternoon, exhausted but happy, and grabbed your favourite cup of noodles to have for dinner. Deku paid you extremely well for being his assistant, and you sighed happily that you wouldn't have to struggle to make ends meet as much as you sat down at the kitchen table to eat your noodles. Just then your phone dinged. It was a message from an unknown number. Shoving a fork full of noodles in your mouth, you clicked on the message. Hi Yin, it's Deku. Noodles came flying out of your mouth and nose. How did he get my number? I got your number from the file. I hope you don't mind. Just wanted to make contact so that you have my number now. Oh, that's how, you thought as you cleaned yourself up. Also, I just realized we didn't celebrate your starting your new job here with me. Thank you for accepting the position. You kept scrolling. One more thing. There's a gala on this weekend and I have a plus one ticket. Would you consider coming with me? You nearly passed out. Well, I guess it's all part of the job, you thought. You replied immediately, thanking him for the opportunity to work with him and accepting to go with him to the gala. There seem to be a lot of dates and outings together. Is it supposed to be like this? You thought. Cat, are you home? Deku called out as soon as he entered his apartment. There was a growl and a bark from his bedroom and he smiled. Cat, come here a second, I need to talk to someone. A very angry-looking Pomeranian trotted out of the bedroom door and glared at him. Did I interrupt your nap, Katsuki? Deku asked his pup. The ball of enraged fluff continued to glare at his owner, and Deku laughed. He'd fallen in love with this little ball of hatred the minute that he laid eyes on it. It reminded him of his childhood friend and close rival, Katsuki Bakugo, another well-known hero. Bakugo and Deku's pup Katsuki sported the same hairstyle and hatred of people, but they were both dearly loved by Deku, and he thought both the human version and the puppy version were pretty cute. Hence why I'd fallen in love with this little bundle of fluff immediately, and named it Katsuki. Cat for short. Cat, this is going to sound weird, but I think I've fallen in love with my printer. I mean, personal assistant. Cat turned and walked off. Hey, whoa, wait up, Cat, Deku called, launching down the hall after his pup. I still love you the most. You're my number one, he said as he caught up to his little ball of anger and scooped him up in his arms. Cat struggled and bared his teeth, but Deku knew it was all a front. You're always going to be my pup, yes? Deku said softly as he buried his face into the Pomeranian's soft fur. But I really like this girl. How do I let her know that I like her? Cat growled. Okay, I know I'm hopeless, Deku said. Would she like flowers, do you think? The angry pup pulled back and looked at him. Okay, flowers then. Do I say they're from me? Cat sneezed. Okay, no? Anonymous? Deku asked the small ball of blonde. The pup looked at him. Okay, anonymous, with a sweet note. Got it, he said with his Deku award-winning smile. I'll get them delivered to her desk tomorrow. You're so helpful, Cat. Thank you. The little dog looked away. You're such a tsundere, Deku laughed, giving Cat a good head scratch and a chin rub. The angry ball melted in his hands. See, I know you like this, Deku said. I know you too well. The next morning, you decided to really throw your A game into this new job and stopped by the coffee shop to get yourself and Deku a coffee each. You knew his order, so wanted to impress him with being that one thoughtful step ahead. You got to work and happily entered his office just as he was ending a call. He quickly put the phone down and blushed like he'd been caught in the act of doing something. Good morning, boss, you said with a cheery smile. Got your coffee for you. You have a 10 a.m. appointment with Go Beyond News, a meet and greet at 12 p.m. with the new board members of Heroes Daily, then a question and answer time at the public school just up the road at 2 p.m. Would you like me to make any adjustments for you regarding today's run sheet? Deku just stared at you in awe. You beamed. Wow, I'm so glad I have you. You're amazing, Deku said, still amazed at how quickly and effortlessly you had fallen into the role. It's like you were born for this. Buddy, this is a dream come true, you said internally. Oh, it's nothing really. I'm just happy to be here and able to help the number one hero, you smiled. Deku grinned. Well, Yin, I would be most grateful if you'd come with me to my appointment so I can, show you off, is what he wanted to say, but he didn't think that was appropriate. Introduce you to people, is how he ended his sentence. I'd love to, you beamed. Deku, you have 10 minutes before your appointment with Go Beyond News. Do you need a glass of water or anything before they arrive? Oh, yes, please, Yin, that would be lovely, he said, looking up from his desk, his eyes darting over your shoulder to watch something go by behind you. You looked, just in time to see a courier walking to your office with a bunch of flowers. Are those for me? You asked curiously. What for you? Deku asked nervously. That guy just put a bouquet of flowers in my office, you said as you walked back to your office to look. The courier smiled at you as he silently left the bunch of gorgeous flowers on your desk and walked out. You walked over to the bunch. There was a note attached. Thank you for being you, it read. You blushed. Did Deku send these to me? And there ends chapter 9. Stay tuned for chapter 10.